What's up, guys? We are in Schladming. And as you can see, I'm not on a Scott today. It's because I'm here with Freeride Magazine. We're doing a test day, and I'm actually going to be testing 6 different downhill bikes. So I'm super excited. I haven't ridden any of these bikes, and I actually haven't ridden a different bike in quite a few years. So it's going to be really interesting to ride the different bikes. Also, different suspension, different brakes, different tires. So for me, it's going to be quite an eye-opener and a really cool experience to be able to try different stuff, and it's not something that you get to do every day. And we're at one of the sickest tracks on the planet. So yeah, excited for it. Let's go have some fun. So on each bike, checking tire pressure, suspension pressure, putting my pedals on, obviously. Some of them I've changed the bar roll because I'm quite sensitive on cockpit feel, which I think a lot of riders are. It's pretty interesting because it's not just that I'm changing frames, I'm also changing tire setups, suspension, different brands, different brakes. So it's not just the frame I'm feeling. So I'm trying to get them to all feel as similar as I can before I start, to try to get like the most accurate gauge. It's not working. We are halfway through the day today. I've done one run on each bike. I'm going to try and get in another run on each bike, which here is a lot because it means I'm doing like 12 or 13 runs or something in Schladming, which is pretty full up. But yeah, having fun. Before you guys go, what I'm going to do at the end of the video is I'm going to give you 5 tips to consider before buying a downhill bike, because all these bikes have different pros and cons. And will suit different riding styles, different tracks. So depending on what you're looking for, there are a few things that you should really think about. Come to the end of a long day here. Put in 11 runs, I think. And yeah, really interesting. The different bikes had different, everything had a pros and cons. Starting out with the Transition, I would say the Transition is really good for like a bike park bike. It was nice and playful, relatively firm setup, quite short in the rear. So really nice for sharping turns and things like that. We move on to the Cube. And for me, that was also more like a bike parky type bike. It could have also been due to the setup, but it was really short in the rear, which, to be honest, for me as a racer, I'm not the biggest fan of. It felt really long up front and quite short in the rear, which makes the bike feel a bit nervous. Yeah, I would say more of a playful bike, at least the one I had. I only had one or two runs on each bike, so it's quite tricky to make these conclusions. But then we move on to the Specialized. I had an S3, which was not really big enough for me, so it was also a bit tricky. And the rear end of the bike was quite soft, so again, hard to give a proper analysis, but I really liked how the rear end of the bike felt. Through the rough stuff, it was really good. It just like smashed through everything. I didn't get any sort of kicking feeling. So I think as a race bike, it's definitely up there with the best of them. We were running Öhlin suspension on it, which, to be honest, I thought was going to be really good, and it didn't feel as amazing as I thought it was going to feel. It didn't feel bad, but felt very hard and harsh, and so I guess it's just a setup thing, because obviously Loic Bruni probably doesn't share the same opinion as me. But again, I think it's more of a setup thing. But I think as a race bike, if it was the right size, and 29 front and back for me, it would have been really good. Then we move on to the Mondraker, again a bike that I didn't really think about too much. But actually really enjoyed it. It's quite stiff, being full carbon. Everything's carbon, links are carbon, everything. So yeah, it was quite stiff, but yet compliant. It's strange. I haven't really had that feeling on a bike before. So really enjoyed that, and it was one of the bikes that I felt like I could get on and just ride. It did have a 30 mil stem on it, which I didn't like. I felt like it was nice through the steep stuff, but in the turns, it just made the front end too light. So I've never been a fan of short stems. I would say 40 is the shortest I'd go. It's quite noisy, but again, could be a bit of a setup thing. I mean, these bikes are new and haven't had much tweaking. And it came with Michelin tires, which I'd also never ridden before. Yeah, really like those as well. So that was something that I felt like I could get on, and I think a day or two on it, and I could probably race it. Next, moving on to the Canyon. Again, the Canyon was actually, I was quite excited to ride it. Heard a lot of positive things about it. I wasn't as impressed with it as I thought I was going to be, and I think it was more of a setup thing than an actual bike thing. The rear end felt really harsh. And I think that the rear spring was too soft, which was meaning I was blowing through the travel. So kind of hard for me to give an honest opinion about it. But definitely in terms of turning and geometry and how playful the bike felt and how it felt, through the majority of the track, I liked it. I could tell that it was more like a race bike. It wouldn't be the bike that I would buy if I was just going to go and have fun in a bike park. I think it's more of a race machine designed to go fast. But again, I would have liked to try it with a different shock setup at the back, because it was just through some of the rough stuff, it felt like a hardtail. And I'm not really sure why, because I'm sure that it can't feel like that for all the guys. Yeah, overall, yeah, it's another good bike. Then moving on to the final bike, which was the Propane. Again, wouldn't have been at the top of my list before the test. Never ridden one before, but yeah, I really liked it. And to be honest, I think in the rear, it was the best through the rough stuff. It was set up as a mullet, and I think if it was a 29er and in the long chainstay position, I would have enjoyed it even more. I really liked it. It was, again, somehow plush at the back, but didn't blow through. So yeah, I felt really stable. Again, it was a bike that I think with very little time, I could race it. And yeah, that was all the bikes. Of course, none of them compared to my Scott, but that wasn't here in the test. No, but yeah, it was a super fun day. I learned actually quite a bit, riding different suspension, different tires, different brakes. It was super interesting to me to compare what I've been on to and setups and stuff to these other bikes. And I was super happy at the end of the day. I got on my bike and it felt like home. And yeah, had a good run on it. So yeah, that's my feedback, my honest thoughts on the bikes. Right. So I promised you guys five tips. So things to think about when you're going to buy a new bike. First of all, what type of riding you want to do? Are you more of a park rat? You want to just go to the bike park and do laps, or do you want to race? Because that is something that you need to think about, the suspension platform, and you want something that plows through or that's nice and poppy. The second thing would be the weight of the bike. Again, if you're a racer, you can have a bike that's got a bit of extra weight on it, because it's actually going to help you in some instances. I actually like having more weight on the bike. It keeps the bike more planted, more stable, more grip. But if you are riding in the bike park and just looking to have fun, then a super light bike is really nice because it's easy. You can pop it, you can jump stuff, you can whip, and it's less fatiguing. Easy to pop on and off of the gondola or shuttle. So really enjoy that. Then the other thing is components. When you're buying a bike, look at the build kit of the bike. And in my opinion, I think it's better to buy a not that there's bad bikes these days, but I would rather choose a worse frame and better components than a amazing frame and really terrible components. I think you can, I mean, it doesn't matter what frame I had. If I had bad components or a bad setup, I won't be able to ride it fast and I won't be comfortable on the bike. Whereas if you had a good setup and good components, even if the frame was not amazing, you'll still be able to feel pretty good. The other thing is whether you want to take a full 29er or a mullet, or even a full 27.5 if you want. With wheel sizes, I ride a full 29. I'm over 6 foot, and I feel like anyone that's over 6 foot, in my opinion, could benefit from a 29er. I just feel like you have more grip on the back, more stability. Bike doesn't move around so much. There are pros to having the mullet, besides the fact that you get more wheel clearance, because that's the biggest reason that people want it, is, especially for shorter guys. But in the steep sections, you don't have to worry about the wheel coming up so much. But I feel like if you're tall enough, then it doesn't really matter. I would say the 29er is, I think it's a bit underrated, because there's this big trend now for everyone riding mullet. But I love the 29er, and I've done quite a lot of testing on the mullets, and yeah, I always come back to that. So whether you're a racer or just looking to have fun, if you're a taller rider, think about just sticking on the 29. It's going to be easier for you, also not having different tires and different rims and all that, and just keeping it simple, and leave the mullet set up for the guys that are being technical at the races. And then the last point to think about is chainstay length. People just look at reach and bike length and wheelbase, which is all well and good, but the length of the bike from the center makes a huge difference. I think they call it the front center. So from your feet to the front axle versus your feet to the rear axle, if that balance is not right, it has a huge effect on how the bike feels. For me, I like a really long back end. I like to feel centered in the bike. And when I'm riding bikes with shorter rear ends, it feels playful. But as soon as you start going fast, it feels too sketchy. The bike feels nervous. The wheel feels like it's underneath you. So if I could put it like this, when the wheel's further away, it's almost like being on a boat and having a rudder behind you. So it kind of like it's easier to steer yourself and it's not so dramatic. Whereas the wheel's underneath you, it's all happening too fast. So if you're a racer, I definitely go for the longer setup. And if you're a bike park rider, then you can get away with a shorter rear end, for jumps and scalloping turns and things like that. Shorter rear end is fine. So it depends if you're looking to play on the bike or get down to business and go racing.